बलिश्यावर राम चंद्र भगवान की जय। बोले वृंदावन बिहारी लाल की जय। पवन सुत हनुमान की जय। उमापति महादेव की जय। राधा रानी की जय। श्रीमद सद्गुरु सरकार की जय। अज्ञानतिमिरांधस्य ज्ञानाञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। बरहापीडं नटवरवपु कर्णयो कर्णिकारं विद्वद्वासः कनककपिशं वैजयंती चमाला रंध्रान वेनु रधर सुधया पूरयं गोप वृंदई वृंदारण्यं स्वपद रमणं प्राविशगीत कीर्ति। वर्णानामर्थ संघाना रसाना छंदसामपि मंगलानाम च कर्तारं वंदे वाणी विनायक। ओम नीलांभुज श्यामल कोमलांगं सीता समारोपित वाम भागं पाणौ महासायक चारु चापं नमामि रामं रघुवंशनाथं। कर्पूर गौरं करुणावतारं संसार सारं भुजगेन्द्रः सदा वसन्तं हृदि भवं भवानि सहितं नमः। ओम मनोजवं मारुततुल्यवेगं जितेन्द्रियं बुद्धिमतां वरिष्ठं वातात्मदं वानरयूथमुख्यं श्रीरामदूतं शरणं प्रपद्ये। सुनन सौ जाय जो ही सुमिरत सिद्धि हो गणना सो शुभ गुण सदना कृपा सुदया प्रभु सकल कलिमल गहना
महादेव की जय। बोले पवन सुत हनुमान की जय। वृंदावन बिहारी लाल की जय। राधा रानी की जय।
इज देयर एनीवन हु कैन प्ले दंताल? नो, डजंट सीम सो। एंड प्लीज पुट अ लिटिल मोर वॉल्यूम इन द ढोलक। दिस बॉय हैंड ही प्लेज वेरी सॉफ्ट, डजंट हियर द ढोलक प्रॉपरली। आदरणीय पंडित जी, प्रिय भक्त समुदाय, विप्र मंडली, महानुभाव, रिस्पेक्टेड पंडित जी और पंडित, देयर इज डिवोटीज ऑफ द सुप्रीम लॉर्ड, द डिवाइन सोल्स, फर्स्ट लेट मी से राधे राधे टू ईच एंड एवरीवन। And my pranam, my humblest prostrations to all of you. Also to our viewers on social media. Facebook, YouTube, and of course Bhakti TV. A very special Radhe Radhe to all of you also. And my pranam. Very special thanks to Pandit Satyananda Maharaj, the spiritual leader of the Satyananda Ashram in Aranwes and the producer of Bhakti TV. And a special thanks to Panditji for bringing this Ramayan Yatra live every night until Ram Navami. So that then so many souls will be able to benefit. We started this Ramayana Yatra last night in Clarkson Bay, Trinidad. Tonight we are in Mission Road, Freeport. As we continue this Yatra, the devotee here the doll and her family, the Babulal family, especially wanted to have this Ramayan in memory of their mother. We all know her as very special devotee of Jagar Gurutam Shri Kripalu Mahaprabhu, and she's known as Moi to everyone. Very special and dear devotee. The 17 years anniversary since she left us physically. So her children, etc., wanted to have the satsang in her memory, and we also doing the second day of our Ramayana Yatra. As we continue tonight in this wonderful journey of this Tulsikirti Ramayana, we're going through the sacred pages of this holy text, Tulsikirti Ramayana. Tulsidas, that great saint Tulsidas Ji Maharaj, I mentioned, wrote this Ramayana based on the philosophy of all the Vedas, or sammat hai, Ved Upanishad ke mat mein. According to the philosophy in the Vedas, Upanishad, etc., Tulsidas Ji wrote this wonderful Ramacharitamanas, the autobiography of Bhagwan Sri Ram, his divine pastimes when he descended in this world in the age of Treta Yuga and stayed 11,000 years. Tulsidas Ji wrote this Ramayana. Originally, Valmiki, that great saint Valmiki, had written the Ramayana in Sanskrit. But understanding that this age is the age of Kali Yuga, and how many people even know Hindi, far less to know Sanskrit. And to understand Sanskrit. So Tulsidas Ji Maharaj wrote the Ramayana in Avadhi, the language of the common man, the common people. So it could be easily understood by everyone, and sang in this way also too. As we begin tonight, before we begin Katha, we'll again sing the praises of the Lord. Bhagwan ka gunagan karna. Kehte hai, hazaro yagya ka Bhagwan ka shlok bolne se, unke shlok bolne se hazaro yagya barabar hai. Aur Bhagwan ka naam lene mein, unke jap naam का जप करने से हजारों श्लोक बराबर है. और भगवान का गुणगान करने हजारों नाम से बराबर है. इट इज सेड इन द स्क्रिप्चर्स, रिसाइटिंग द डिवाइन मंत्रस डेडिकेटेड टू भगवान, द श्लोक्स मंत्रस इज इक्वल टू मिलियंस ऑफ yagnas performed in the right way. More than that, chanting the name of the Lord, any name of the Lord, is equal to millions of mantras being chanted. And greater than that, chanting the glories of the Lord, his pastimes, attributes, etc., is greater than even millions of names. So we chant the divine glories of the Lord, a beautiful bhajan, page 12 in the booklets. This beautiful bhajan written by Jagat Gurutam Kripalu Mahaprabhu is describing the beauty of the Lord. That Sri Ram, Sri Krishna is so beautiful. Remember, Bhagwan Sri Ram, Sri Krishna are one and the same. We should not see difference, not even 0.00001%. We should not see any difference. How beautiful is the Lord? The most beautiful person in the material world is told to be Kamdev, the god of love, To describe how beautiful Sri Ram is, Sri Krishna is, the scriptures tells us and the saints that he is more beautiful than the beauty of uncountable Kamdevas combined. He is so beautiful that Shuka Sankadik, when they saw the Lord, they meditate on the formless aspect. But when they saw that beautiful Lord, they started staring at him without even blinking. In the Maharas, the Lord, filling his eyes with divine love, looked at Shankar Bhagwan. And Shankar Bhagwan forgot his samadhi and got engrossed in that divine beauty of the Lord. Uma Rama Parvati, Mahalakshmi, Saraswati, etc. They forgot their Patibrat Dharm, seeing the beauty of that divine Lord. So beautiful he is. We'll sing a few verses, beautiful bhajan.
Thank you.
वृंदावन बिहारी लाल की जय। सियावर रामचंद्र की जय।
प्रभु जाते हो
बोले सियावर रामचंद्र भगवान की जय। लास्ट नाइट मैंने कहा था कि जब भगवान श्री राम लक्ष्मण और मां सीता चित्रकूट में थे तो एक दिन भगवान बड़े सुख से आराम से बैठे थे तो लक्ष्मण जी महाराज ने सोचा कि ये सुनहरे अवसर है प्रभु से कुछ पूछना। तो एक प्रश्न लक्ष्मण ने पूछा कि माया क्या है और कल रात ये सुनाया और कई प्रश्न पूछा उन्हें पूछा कहो ज्ञान विराग अरु माया और कहो सो भक्ति करहु जेहि दाया। I told you last night, once when Bhagwan Shri Ram, the mother of the universe, Ma Sita and Lakshman were in Chitrakoot during the 14 years of banishment. One day, Bhagwan Shri Ram was sitting very comfortably in Lakshman Ji. Thought this is a golden opportunity. Let me ask the Lord some question. As I mentioned last night, Bhagwan Shri Krishna says to Arjun, we have to ask question when we have doubt. If we don't clarify the doubt, it gets worse. One doubt, everything is destroyed. Sanshaya Atma Vinashyati. Who to ask? So Bhagavan Krishna says in chapter 4, verse 34 of the Gita, Jnaninaha Tatpradarshinaha. The person we ask from must be qualified. Qualified. How is he qualified? Number one, Jnaninaha. He must have complete knowledge. All the Vedas, all the Puranas, Mahabharata, Ramayana, Gita, all the scriptures. Complete knowledge. Plus he is able to remove our doubts. He clarifies our doubts. That is Jnaninaha. But even more important, he has to be Tatpradarshinaha. He has seen God, attained God. He is Bhagavan himself. One who attains God attains all the powers of Bhagavan. There's no difference between God and one who attains God.
ददामि बुद्धि योगं तम येन माम उपयान्ति ते. Chapter 10, verse 10, Gita. Shri Krishna says to Arjuna, when one attains God realization, everything that Shri Krishna has, he gives to the soul. Infinite knowledge, infinite bliss, everything divine. This is why Naraji says in Narad Bhakti Sutra, Tasmins Tajane Bheda Bhavart. Narad Bhakti Sutra. There's no difference between God and one who has attained God, the true saint, the true guru. So Shri Krishna is qualifying who is the guru and who we should ask question from. So of course, Bhagwan Shri Ram is qualified. Lakshman knew this. So Lakshman asks many important things in a very short way. What is true gyan, knowledge? What is meant by detachment, virag? Maya, we already answered last night. And what is that bhakti? The thing which is called bhakti, through which the only, through which that path that you shower your grace, only through the path of bhakti, Bhagwan showers his grace. And we're able to know him, attain him, attain the divine love, divine bliss, divine knowledge, only when he showers his grace. And that is a part of bhakti. What is this part of bhakti? These questions. What is the difference of Ishwar, Bhagwan, God, and Jeev, the individual soul? Please tell me these things. Lakshman is asking. So as I told you last night, Bhagwan said to Lakshman, I'm going to answer you very shortly, in a very short way. Sankshep. I'm not going to give very long explanation. So pay very close attention and listen carefully. So let's hear the rest of the answers Bhagwan Shri Ram is given to Lakshman. मान जह एक नाही देखत ब्रह्म रूप सब नाही. भगवान श्री राम सेज लक्ष्मण, व्हाट इज ज्ञान? द थिंग नॉलेज. हाउ, हु इज अ ज्ञानी? वन हु रियलाइजेस आई एम द सोल आत्मा, आई एम नॉट द बॉडी. अज्ञानी मींस वन हु डज नॉट नो हु दे आर, हु आइडेंटिफाइज विद द बॉडी. ऑल ऑफ अस. That's why we keep rotating in 8.4 million forms of life. So Jnani, one who realizes I am the soul Atma, and he does not see differences. Oh, he is a Brahman, he is Kshatri, he is Shudra, he is Vaishya. No. He sees equality everywhere because he sees the soul everywhere. Number one. He does not see high and low. Not only that, he sees Brahma, God in every being.
Ishvara sarva bhutanam hriddeshe junatishthati brahmayan sarva bhutani yantaruhani mayaya.
Chapter 18, verse 61, Gita. Bhagavan Krishna says to Arjun, God is sitting in the heart of every living being. He's pervading in every particle of the world. So the Jnani is one who sees God everywhere, in everyone. The Lord is sitting. Then he's a Jnani. If he sees differences, then he's not a Jnani. Oh, he's a Brahman, he's a Kshatri, Shudra, he's a Vaishya. There's a donkey, there's a cat, there's an elephant. No. Everywhere he sees equality. God everywhere. That's what is Jnan. And that is a Jnani.
Akahiya tata so parama viragi tina samasiddhi tina guna tyagi.
And who is a tyagi? Who is a true detached person? This word detachment. People say, I don't eat meat, I don't drink alcohol, I am detached. Is that detachment? What is detachment?
Detachment only happens when one realizes that there is no happiness to be found in any person or object in the world, and the happiness I am looking for I'll find only in Sri Ram, only in Sri Krishna. Only a person who has made a decision in the mind firmly can be detached. Otherwise impossible. From beginningless time we have been looking for happiness. It's our nature, being a fraction of happiness. We can't help it. Everywhere and every action we perform is only for happiness. But because of ignorance, because of attachment, we are looking in the wrong place in the material world. So first that knowledge has to come. Number one, I am the soul, Atma, I am not the body. Number two, the happiness I am looking for, I will find only in Sri Ram. Because Sri Ram is happiness. Another name for Sri Ram is Anand. Chidanandamay. He is Anand, bliss, happiness. Then, such a person does not, he looks at everything in the world like dirt. Mati hai mati. The house, the motor car, everything is all dirt. People, there's something called siddhis. Powers to perform miracles. Bhagavan Sri Ram says to Lakshman, there are three types. Tamasic siddhis, Rajasic siddhis, Sattvic siddhis. Tamasic is the lowest. A person has tamasic siddhis. How would you know? He shows you his hand or a bowl and asks you, what do you see? Empty. Then he says, okay, look again. When you look, oh, gold, coins, almonds, jewel. And you are amazed. This man is a great saint. When in fact, he is invoking ghosts and spirit, bhoot and preet, to make these things appear. And do you know what the scripture says about people who possess such siddhis? The scriptures,
They qualify these siddhis as tamasic siddhis, rakshasi. And people who possess such siddhis, they go to the worst hell, Raurava Narak. Not only that, people who believe in such people and go to them, they also go to Raurava Narak. Higher in rajasic siddhi is tamasic rajasic siddhi. A person who possesses the siddhi possesses the power to cure illnesses, diseases, etc. Higher in rajasic siddhi, sattvic siddhis. A person possesses sattvic siddhi, anima, laghima, garima, etc. He can become so light, hundreds of people, he'll just fly like a feather, he'll blow away. Or he can become so heavy that hundreds of people won't be able to lift him up. He can fly in the sky, walk on water and fire. He can remain buried under the ground for days. He can enter your mind and know exactly what you're thinking. If you meet a person possessing such siddhis, you will think he is Bhagavan himself, God. But these siddhis are very dangerous. Very dangerous. They all belong to the mayic or material realm. And one who gets attracted to these siddhis can never attain bhakti or divine love. They can never attain God. It becomes the greatest impediment, obstacle in God realization. This is why devotees are especially warned not to be attracted by siddhis, the material siddhis, the rajasic, tamasic and sattvic siddhis. So he says here, tin sama siddhi tin guna tyagi. A true devotee, tyagi, looks upon siddhis like dry grass. The word trin means dry grass, has no attraction. Nanaka prishtam nacha sarva bhaumam na parameshtam na mahendra dhishnam na yoga siddhi rapunar bhavam va vanchanti yat padarjah prasannah. Bhagavat Mahapuran. The Bhagavat Mahapuran says, one who is devoted to the lotus feet of the Lord, only such a person can be a tyagi. His mind is totally detached from the world because his mind is totally attached to Bhagavan now. You cannot be detached and attached at the same time to the world. You have to be at the mind, has to be attached somewhere. So detached from the world, attached to Bhagavan. Or attached to Bhagavan, detached from the world. It's like a scale, balance. Long ago, we didn't have digital scales. There were two plates with chain and they had a balance. How do you used to weigh things? On one side you put the things to weigh, on the other side you put the weight. If it's equal, it will be balanced. If one side is heavier, one will go up, one will go down. When our attachment for the material world is very great, our love, our attachment for the material world is very great, we have no love, no attachment for God. The scale is like this. Zero or very little. They have no time with Bhagavan, God. There's satsang. They've been invited. It's a waste of time. There's no entertainment. They want entertainment. They don't want to hear about God, Bhagavan, about loving God. Manoranjan. So there's no interest. They do puja, etc. With the hope that maybe if there's a Bhagavan, he'll bless me with more material things. As our attachment for the material world starts to decrease, the scale starts moving up, our attachment for Bhagwan, for God, will start increasing. And when detachment has become zero, we have no attachment for any personal object in the world, we will be totally attached in love with God. We have attained God realization. A person cannot be impossible, attached to the material world, loving mother, father, wife, husband, children, dog, cat, murukans, I am a devotee of Bhagwan. That's the greatest ignorance, delusion. The more love and attachment we have for the material world, the further we have, we are away from God. Further away. You can know for yourself. Well, if you're a true devotee, how much attachment you have for material people and objects in the world. Your own mother, father, wife, husband, child, material possessions, etc. See how much attachment you have. You can know. Nobody has to tell you. Without detachment from the material world, we cannot love God. Impossible. Because we only have one mind. And with that one mind, either we love the world or we love Bhagwan. Very simple. We fool ourselves. I am a devotee. I love God. But I love the world. I love my wife. I love my husband. I love my child. Anybody touch my child, I'll kill them. Jai ho. And you're a devotee. So here in Bhagavad Mahapuran it said, a person who is devoted to the lotus feet of Bhagwan looks upon all material pleasures. The position of Indra, the king of heaven, the position of Brahma, the creator, the powers to perform miracles, siddhis, and even moksha, liberation, has been undesirable. Not even the slightest attachment, not even the slight, they don't even think about it. If you have true love, Bhagavat Mahapuran is said, a great saint, Rup Goswami says in the Bhakti Samit Sindhu, Bhukti Mukti Spihayavat Pishachi Hridivartate Tavat Bhakti Sukhasyata Kathama Bhidayo Bhavet. Bhakti Samit Sindhu, Bhukti and Mukti have been called Pishachini. Pishachini means churail, witches. Bhukti means desire for the material world, the pleasures of the material world, plus the pleasures of heaven combined, this is called bhukti. And mukti means liberation. Rup Goswami, that great saint, is here calling both of them churail, witches, demons. He says as long as the desire for these two demons are there in the heart of an individual, Bhakti Mahadevi, or the goddess of divine love, can never come. You cannot be a devotee. Impossible. You can tell everybody. Anybody can say anything. But the reality is a different thing. You have to be detached. Virag. Bhagavan Krishna says in Gita, when Arjun said, how to control this mind, how to focus the mind on Bhagwan. In chapter 6, Bhagwan Krishna is telling Arjun to focus the mind, to meditate on God. He's teaching Arjun how to meditate, teaching us. Arjun says, Chanchalami manah Krishna pramati balavadhiram tasyahandikahammanye vayu rivasurushkaram. How to control this mind is so wayward. Because it's so attached to the material world, it keeps running to the material world. It is more difficult to control the mind than it is to control the wind. And Bhagwan agreed. Bhagwan Krishna said, Asanshayam mahabaho mano durunigraham chalam. Yes, Arjun. I agree with you 100%. The mind is indeed difficult to control. not impossible, difficult, because it's so attached from beginningless time. It has been attached to the material world. Because it has made a firm decision, I will find happiness in the world, in the material world. A new house, a new car, handsome boy, beautiful girl, lots of money, etc. If not today, tomorrow, but I will, because of ignorance. That's why it's so difficult. But it can be done. How? Abhyasina tu kaunteya vairagyena cha grihyate. Chapter 6 verse 35 Gita. Through constant practice, constantly associating with the true saint, those who have attained God realization, true knowledge, that we acquire true knowledge from them. That's the abhyas. Constantly. And vairagya, detachment. You see, Bhagwan mentions here vairagya. When true knowledge will come, vairagya will happen by itself. Plus the grace of the saint. It's something people in the world can't understand. How can you not care about that person? That person has done so much. How can you not love this one? Love. The mind has been taken somewhere else. Someone has taken the mind. Krishna has stolen the mind. Kripalu Mahaprabhu has stolen the mind. What to do? Because it hasn't happened to you, so it's impossible for you to understand. Because your mind is still so attached in the material world. So detachment, vairagya has to happen. Then, attachment for God, love for God. Then you can know devotion. Then you can do bhakti. Otherwise, you'll do something. But you have a long way to go. Doha.
Maya Nishna Aaputa Jan Jan Kahil So Jeev Rama Jan Kahil So Jeev Bandha Moksha Prag Sarva Kar Maya Tirat Sinh Rama Maya Tirat Sinh Siya Ram Shankar Jai Shankar Shankar Jai Shankar Jai Jai
ईश्वर भगवान और जीव में क्या भेद है? क्या हम एक है कि भगवान ही जीव है जैसे ज्ञानी लोग कहते हैं, या इसमें भेद है? सो लक्ष्मण जाक्सन भगवान, दिस पार्ट ऑफ द रामायण इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड राम गीता. देयर आर मेनी सेक्शंस लाइक दिस, बट दिस इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड राम गीता. Just as Arjun is asking question in the Bhagavad Gita and Bhagavan Krishna is given answer, in the same way Lakshman Ji Maharaj is asking question and Bhagavan Sri Ram is given the answer. Now, the question was, what's the difference between God, that thing we call God, Bhagavan, Ishwar, Paramatma, Sri Krishna, Sri Ram, and Jeev, the individual soul, Atma? Is there a difference? Or as the Jnani says, Aham Brahmasmi, I am God, the soul is God. Is there a difference? Or are we Bhagwan? Now we don't know. Bhagwan Sri Raman answers and says, Lakshman, inko Jeev kahete hai jo apne ko nahi jante. जो माया को नहीं जानते, अपनों को नहीं जानते और भगवान को भी नहीं जानते, उनको जीव कहते हैं और ज्ञानी है. भगवान से लक्ष्मण, दैट एंटिटी दैट डज नॉट नो हु दे आर, दे डोंट नो हु दे आर, दे डो नॉट नो व्हाट इज माया, They don't know who is Bhagwan, who is God. Such an entity is called Jeev, individual soul. We people. And Bhagwan?
Gya gyau dva vaja visha nisha vaja heka bhokti bhogyata yukta anantas chatma vishwarupo hyakarta tayam yada vindate brahma me tat.
Shvetashvatara Upanishad chapter 1 verse 9. The Vedas, the scriptures are telling us Bhagwan, that entity we call Bhagavan, God, Paramatma, Supreme Power, is the governor of Maya as well as the individual soul, Jeev. There's a big difference between God and the individual soul. There are two things that we're equal to in God. God is, we're equal to Bhagwan in two things. Number one, God is anadi, ajanm, aj. God is unborn, eternal, beginningless. We, the individual souls, are also unborn, eternal, beginningless. We never had a beginning, we'll never have an end. The second thing, God is chetan, conscious. We, the individual souls, are also conscious. But there's a big difference. He is vibhu chit, vibhu chit, infinitely conscious. While the jivatma, the individual soul, is anuchit, anuchit. Very small conscious. Let me give an example. The sun gives light. When the sun comes, the whole world gets bright. Now there are other things that gives light also. Copper, gold, brass, they also give light. But if you put it in a dark place, you cannot see the light. You will not see the light. This is a close example as the difference between. So God is Surya Sam. Bhagwan is like the sun, the brightness, and the individual soul. the consciousness is like the brightness in the gold, in the brass, in the copper. You put in the darkness, you can't see. Such a big difference. And this is just an example. It's much more times than that. God is infinite knowledge. While we are agyan, agyani, we have very little knowledge or we know nothing at all. So many, many differences between Bhagwan, Ishwar and Jeev. And by knowing that Supreme Lord Bhagwan, the individual souls become free from Maya. He attains liberation. He becomes liberated from Maya. And he attains God realization forever.
Ram, Sia Ram, Sia Ram, Jai Jai Ram.
Ram, Sia Ram, Sia Ram, Jai Jai Ram. Ram, Sia Ram, Sia Ram, Jai Jai Ram. Dharma te dhirati jote te jana jaru chutra te dhirati bakha bolo Ram Sia Ram Sia Ram Jai Jai Ram Ram Sia Ram Sia Ram Jai Jai Ram जाते देगी प्रभाव में भाई
सियावर राम चंद भगवान की जय। टू द परफॉर्मेंस ऑफ धर्म One's duties in the world, varnashram dharma, I'm not going to go in great detail. Detachment comes, birati. True yoga, ashtang yoga. Yoga doesn't mean exercise, yoga. Yoga means yam, niyam, asan, pranayam, pratyahar, dharana, dhyan, samadhi. It's called yoga, impossible in Kali Yuga. One attains Gyan, knowledge. And through Gyan, one attains Moksha. Gyan Moksha Pada Veda Bakana. This is what the Vedas say. This is all impossible in Kali Yuga. All. Kali Yuga Jogana Jagya Gyana. Kagda Sundarji is saying to Guruji Maharaj in the Kali Yuga Mahima of the Ramayana Uttarakhand. कलयुग जोग न यज्ञ ज्ञाना हे काग सुंदर जी हे गुरु जी द पाथ ऑफ ज्ञान द पाथ ऑफ योग द पाथ ऑफ धर्म ऑल इंपॉसिबल इन कलयुग कांट डू व्हाट टू डू एक आधार राम गुण गाना चांद नेम ऑफ द लॉर्ड टू भक्ति लव द लॉर्ड दैट्स ऑल So, the Vedas tells about these paths. Lekin, jaate dek dravau mein bhai, so mama bhakti bhakt sukhdai. But that path to which I'm easily attained, which pleases me the most, I melt. Dravau means melt. I easily melt. Bhagwan says that path which I easily melt, I'm easily attained, this path called bhakti. What is bhakti? People say, I'm doing devotion, bhakti. I'm singing bhajan, I'm doing bhakti. I'm lighting a diya, I'm doing bhakti. That is bhakti? Do you understand what bhakti means? Naraji says, describes bhakti in Narad Bhakti Sutra. He says, sa tasmin param prema rupa. Narad Bhakti Sutra, second mantra. Naraji, Bhakti ke Acharya, is a guru of Bhakti. There are two guru of Bhakti. One is Sandilya Muni, one is Naraji. Naraji is defined in Bhakti. Naraji says, the supreme and immortal love for God is called Bhakti. Loving God above all, beyond all and everything. When you love God to the point that nothing in the world has any interest for you. No one and nothing in the world. Then you're doing bhakti. Then you know bhakti. Then you can say you're bhakt. The Lord says that person is called a bhakt, a devotee of mine. And he attains, he's always happy, always in divine bliss. The path of bhakti. Sa paravu rakti rishware Sandilya Muni. Sandilya Sutra. In the Vedas, Sandilya Muni is also defined in bhakti. He says, an intense yearning and longing for God. That if I don't see the Lord next moment, I will die. Like you take a fish out of water and you bring it on dry land. What happens to the fish? It beats and flops itself, gasping for breath until it goes back in the water. When you feel like that for God, that the next moment if you don't, you will die like the fish
will die if it doesn't go back in the water. Then you're bhakt, then you're devotee. Do we know that? Do we have that love and that yearning to see Shri Krishna, to see Shri Ram? We're doing puja, we're doing this. Why are you doing the puja? Because I'm getting problem in my job. I don't have a good enough job yet. I want to pass my exam. Somebody is sick. That is bhakti. How we call that bhakti? No, that's not bhakti. That is begging or business. You go to the store and you give the storekeeper $10 and they give you $10 worth in, or $100 worth in exchange. Vyapar, business. We try to make deal with Bhagwan. Hey Bhagwan, if I pass my exam, my wife is very sick, she get better, I will offer 10 pong of prasad. So if you believe in Bhagwan, why don't you offer the prasad before? Acha, and if my wife die, who's going to stand the loss of his 10 pong of prasad? And we say we are devotees. We love God. We have no idea about bhakti. What loving God means. Because we're so attached to this material world. We're so touched. And it's very hard. Almost impossible to convince the worldly soul that there is no happiness to be found in any person or object in the world, that we have to love only Bhagawan, only Shri Ram. Anybody starts telling anyone that, pagal hai, take him to sentence. Crack! Love God, love God. And we claim to be devotees. As Bhagwan is saying. This is what I am easily attained. I melt. Jate begi. Begi means very quickly, very quickly. Very quickly I melt. By the one who loves me. Who does this bhakti. Swatanta avalambana ana tehi adin gyana vigyana bhakti. This part of bhakti is so great. People don't understand what bhakti. They think bhakti is just singing bhajan, and that's why they don't understand the greatness of bhakti. The part of bhakti
doesn't need any other path. It doesn't need a help. It is Swatantra. The word Swatantra means Bhagwan is saying, Sri Ram is saying to Lakshman, the path of bhakti doesn't require gyan, it doesn't require yoga, doesn't require puja, rituals, dharma. No. Bhakti is totally independent, free. Swatantra avalambana ana doesn't require the help of any other path. Or teri adhin jnana vijnana. Every other path needs bhakti. Karma, dharma alone will give us heaven, swarg. Useless. If we add bhakti to karma, it becomes karma yoga. The teachings of the Gita that will give us God realization. Gyan alone will give us self realization. That Gyani falls again and again. If we add bhakti, it becomes Gyan yoga. That person attains God realization. Bhakti is required everywhere. Every path needs the help of bhakti. Bhakti doesn't require the help of anybody. It's Swatantra, completely independent, free. Bhakti tar anupama sukamula milai jo sant hoi anukula. Bhakti is the root of all happiness. Infinite, indescribable happiness. The happiness of bhakti, nothing in the world can compare the happiness of God. God is happiness. The name for Bhagwan is happiness. Infinite bliss. The things you define happiness in the world, something gives happiness. One moment it gets happiness, next moment the same thing gives sorrow to you. Where is the happiness? When a person does what we want in the world, I love you. They don't do what you want, I hate you. One person is getting happiness from drinking alcohol. Another person wants to vomit if you bring alcohol close to him. There are people who love to eat sweet things. Ice cream, cake, chocolate. There are people who will vomit if you try to eat sweet things. Not only that, even in that thing you're getting happiness, after a while you stop getting happiness and you start experiencing sorrow. Let's suppose when someone gets happiness in eating ice cream. Ice cream? When you eat the first ice cream, second ice cream, third ice cream, sixth ice cream, please don't give me any more ice cream. Are you getting happiness? Eat more ice cream. No, I'm going to vomit. No, you stop. You don't get any. So the happiness gets less and less and less until the point you start experiencing pain and suffering. You know, in the morning when the sun rises, the shadow is very long. And as the sun goes up and up until the mid, then it reaches the midday sun, the shadow gets so small, it becomes one with you. That's the happiness of the material world. In the beginning, we get the most happiness, and it gets less, less, less until nothing. And when the sun starts to set, the shadow gets longer and longer until the point you can't see it anymore. That's divine happiness. When we love God, it gets more, it keeps increasing forever. There's no end. There's no end to it. Infinite happiness, infinite bliss. So this is the happiness Bhagwan is saying to Lakshman. Anupam sukamula. Or milo jusanta hoi anukula. And how are we going to get that bhakti? By ourselves? Can we attain this bhakti by ourselves? Let me just go and start thinking about Bhagwan, worshipping Bhagwan. No. Bhagwan Sri Ram is saying to Lakshman, only through the grace of one who has attained that divine love himself, that bhakti. Only through his grace can we attain that bhakti, that divine love. In other words, only through the grace of a rasik saint. We have to take shelter from a rasik saint, one who has attained that divine love of Sitaram, Radha, Krishna himself. Look, someone has to have something to give it. If that person himself is a beggar, what can he give to others? And this is why we get nothing in the material world. How many of us have guru? Almost everybody has a guru. But what Guruji has to give you? Nothing. Zero. He is a beggar and you are also a beggar. Beggar is begging from beggar. Why we want guru? Guru is the one who is going to give us divine knowledge, divine bliss. He is going to give us Bhagawan. Bhagawan is, guru is the one who is going to free us from Maya. When he himself is under Maya, he himself is in darkness, how can he give light? When he himself is a beggar, how can he give happiness to us? Huh? Socho na. Think. And yet we keep saying, my Guruji, my Guruji, my... You want to hear something? Don't get angry. Ved mantra. Ajame. Ajame kam lohit. इष्टापूर्तम मन्यमाना वरिष्ठम नान्यच्छेयो वेदयन्ति प्रमूढ़ा नाकस्य पृष्ठेते सुकृतेन भूतं लोकमितनं विशान् विशन्ति. अंधे नैव नियमाना यथान्धाः. Mundak Upanishad, first Mundak, second Kan, eighth mantra. The Vedas say, material people in the world, they may have read a lot of book. They have read a lot of book, they have acquired knowledge. Intellect, they have acquired book knowledge. They have no experience of divinity. They misinterpret the scriptures and say, happiness is in the world. Pray to God for the world. Happiness is in heaven. They are fools. Moodha. And those who believe in them and follow them is a case of blind leading the blind. When we accept someone as a guru who has not attained God realization, is not qualified, he's under Maya. In other words, he is blind. And we are also blind. It's a straight case of blind leading the blind. Not me saying, babe. First Mundak, Mundak Upanishad. First Mundak, second Kand, eighth mantra. Check it out. So, the guru, the one who has attained the true guru, one who has attained that divine love for Sitaram, Radha, Krishna. When we take shelter in him, we are favorable. In other words, we follow his instruction, anukula, agya palan. He will give us that bhakti. Let's continue.
नव धातु विहारी मम लीलारति मति अतुतानि बोलो श्रीराम
This bhakti, most famous, there are many types of bhakti. Bahut prakar ke hai. Most famous, shravanadik nav bhakti. Shravanadik nav bhakti didhai. Ninefold devotion. As described in Bhagavad Mahapuran by Prahlad to his father Hiranyakashipu. Prahlad ji Maharaj says, Shravanam Kirtanam Vishnu Smaranam Padasevanam Archanam Bandhanam Dasyam Sakhyam Atmani Vedanam. Bhagavat Mahapuran 7th Canto 5th Chapter 23rd Verse. Bhagavan Sri Ram is saying the same. Shravanadi, starting with Shravan Bhakti, listening to divine philosophy through a qualified guru, a qualified saint. Otherwise, you get confused. Kirtanam, chanting the divine name of the Lord. Shravanam, Kirtanam, Smaranam, lovingly meditating on the Lord. Remembering His glory, His virtues, etc. Padasevanam, worshipping the lotus feet of the Lord. Archanam, number 5. Worshipping an image of the Lord. Vandanam, number 6. Prostrating to Bhagwan before the Lord. Number 7. Dasyam. Realizing that the Lord is my master, I am His servant. We are eternal servants of the Lord. So we have to do seva, we have to serve the Lord. Number 8. Sakyam. Realizing the Lord is our eternal friend. He's always with us. He never leaves us even for a moment. Wherever we go, the Lord goes with us. Even when we go to hell, He goes with us. Our eternal friend. And number 9, Atmanivedanam, offering everything unto the Lord. Having firm faith in the 9 forms of devotion. Dridha. Amama lila rati mati adhikai. And having great love. Ati. Great love for listening to my divine pastimes, my divine glories, etc. This is bhakti, the Lord says. Sant charan pankaja ati prema. To have extreme love for the lotus feet of the saints, sant, those who have attained God realization. Knowing them to be God personified. When we meet a true saint, we meet Bhagawan himself. But what happens when the saints come in this world? Look at history. When saints have come in the world, Tulsidas, Surdas, Meera, Tukaram, Gaurang Mahaprabhu, Sri Jagat Gurutam Kripalu Mahaprabhu, what did we do? We curse, criticize, give them a bad name, throw them in jail. This is what we do when the saints come in the world. Instead of worshipping them, having extreme love for the lotus feet, we want to kill them, destroy them. Because they're going to come and, you know why we do that? Because they're going to come and tell us everything we're doing is wrong. We are misinterpreting the scriptures. And nobody wants to hear that. Because we think we know everything. So we said, let's do some propaganda. Get rid of him. Spread some propaganda. Give him a bad name. This is what we do. Amana kama bachan na bhajan vidhanema. And with words, thoughts and deeds, worship the Lord according to the rules and regulations outlined by the saints. They will teach us how to do bhakti. How to love the Lord. How to do bhakti. Again he says, we'll be right back.
सु बंधु पति देवा सब मोहित जाने सेवा बोलो राम 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 राम
रामचंद्र भगवान की जय। गुरु पितु मातु बंधु पति देवा सब मोहि कहै जाने दृढ़ सेवा। द लॉर्ड सेज सी एवरीवन एंड एवरीथिंग इन मी ऑल योर रिलेशन इन मी अलोन। आई एम गुरु आई एम मदर आई एम फादर आई एम योर फ्रेंड आई एम योर हस्बैंड योर वाइफ एवरी रिलेशन यू कैन थिंक अबाउट because we are the soul atma. You know, we say people in the world we call ourselves Hindus. If we don't do any prayer, we know one prayer. Tvameva mata cha pita tvameva tvameva bandhuscha sakha tvameva tvameva vidya द्रविणं त्वमेव त्वमेव सर्वं मम देव देव। Everybody says this prayer, but do we accept what the prayer is saying? We lie to God, we lie. Twam you, Ev alone, to He. We are saying to God, Hey Shri Krishna, Hey Shri Ram, you alone are my mummy, my mama, you alone are my father, Twameva Mata, Chapita Twameva, you alone are my papa, my father, you alone are my friend, you alone are my companion, you alone are my knowledge, you alone are my wealth, you alone are my everything, Twameva Sarabam Mama Deva Deva. Do we have that feeling in our heart when we say that prayer? No. We lie. That God alone is my mother. What about my mother in the house? What about my father in the house? God alone is my money. What about the money in the bank? Huh? There's no feeling. We just say words to Bhagwan. You don't get anything for saying words. The kingdom of God is not in words. Bhagwan doesn't care about words. Whether you know Sanskrit or English or Spanish or French or Italian. Bhagwan doesn't have a language problem, bhaiya. Bhagwan looks to see how much love we have for him. That's all he cares about. Prem. Prem sagai. Sabse uchi prem sagai. Sabse uchi prem sagai. The highest is the relation of love. God only cares how much we love Him. Don't have love, Bhagwan is very far away. Very far. He refused to eat chappan bhog. 56 type of the best things prepared by Duryodhan. And he ate the chilka, the banana peel given by Vidurani with great relish. He ate the jutha, the plums that Shabari tasted. The low, such a low class lady. Bill. Forest dweller. Wild people. You call people who live in the forest wild people. He ate the jutha.
Why? Because of the love Shabari gave. Because of the love with which Bidurani gave. This is what he wants. Doesn't care to do. You give the best thing in the world and there's no love, Bhagwan doesn't care. But Chuvikana, he's not going to even touch it. So, every relation. Sarva mohi kaha jane dridha seva. Knowing with firm dridha, that firm knowledge that God alone is my everything. Every relation is only with the Lord. And do his seva, serve him as you would serve mother, father, wife, has served the Lord in the same way. Then we can love. When we make a relation, then we can love. Then we can do bhakti. Otherwise, we can't. Mama guna gaavata pulakai sharira gadagara gira nayana bahaneera. Ha, bhaiya. We chant bhajan and kirtan. We chant mantras. Does anything happen? Does anything happen in our heart? Here the Lord is saying, while chanting my glories, my virtues, pulakka sharira, the paws and the body you should raise on ends, goosebump. Pulakka sharira. The paws should raise on ends. Gadagad gira. The throat should become choked with emotion. It becomes impossible to talk. Nayana bahanira, tears should flow from the eyes like a river. That's how we are supposed to do bhakti, chant bhajan. Otherwise, we do nothing. In Bhagavad Mahapuran it says, Tadashmasaram hridayam batedam yad grihyamane harinam adheyaihi navikriyetath yadavikaru netre jalam gatruheshu harshah. Bhagavat Mahapuran, second canto, third chapter, 24th verse. The Bhagavat says someone is chanting the name of God. He's worshipping God. But the heart doesn't melt with love. The paws and the body doesn't raise on end. Goosebump. And tears doesn't flow from the eyes like a river. That heart must be made of steel, thunderbolt. Tarashmasadam hridayam batedam. And we are chanting and we're just thinking about, I hope everybody love how I sing. Man, I better than Hari Om Sharan, I better than Shreya Goshalo, what that person named. I can give all them competition. And it is entertainment, that's all. There's no love, no bhakti. Bhagwan says, no. Ah, sing sweet, no problem. But these things are supposed to happen. Bachan kam man mohi gati bhajan karahi nishkam. He says, with words, thoughts and deeds, your aim, the aim of a devotee is only to come to me. His gati, his aim in life, when I'm going to see the Lord, when I'm going to see Sri Ram, when am I going to see Sri Krishna? This is the aim of a devotee. Bhajan karai nishkam. When he worships me, there's no desire. When we do bhakti, we should not have desire for anything. As I said, many of us do puja. Why? I want to pass my exam. I want to get a good job, a better job. I want to win the lotto. I want somebody to get. That's how we call that bhakti. The Lord. No. Nishkam praying. The word nishkam, Sri Ram is saying here. Nishkam means without desires. There should be no desire for anything, for one's own happiness. Avtinke hridaye kamala maha karau sada vishram. In such a person's heart, the Lord says, I live forever. In the lotus heart of such an individual, one who thinks about me all the time, words, thoughts and deeds to come to me, when will he see me? And loves me without any interest, without any desire. In the heart of such a devotee,
I live forever. There you will find me. There's much more. We'll hear another time.
बोले श्यावर राम चंद्र भगवान की जय, उमापति महादेव की जय, पवन सुत हनुमान की जय, जय जय श्री राधे, जय जय श्री राधे, जय जय श्री राधे।